There's a girl in the corner with tear stains on her eyes. From the places she's wandered and the shame she can't hide, she says, how did I get here? I'm not who I once was, and I'm crippled by the fear that I've fallen too far to love. But don't you know who you are, what has been done for you? Don't you know who you are? You are more than the choices that you've made. You are more than the sum of your past mistakes. You are more than the problems you create. You've been remade. Well, she tries to believe it, that she's been given new life. But she can't shake the feeling, well, that it's not true tonight. She knows all the answers, and she's rehearsed all the lines. And so she'll try to do better, but then she's too weak to try. Oh. But don't you know who you are? Mistakes, you are more than the problems you create. You've been remade. You are more than the choices that you've made. You are more than the sum of your past mistakes. You are more than the problems you create. You've been remade. You've been remade. You've been
It's so easy for us sometimes to think that we've sinned too much to be forgiven. It's so easy sometimes for us to look at the sins that we've committed and say, you know, there's no way that there is a God that's going to forgive me of these sins that I committed in my life. They're too bad. They're too horrible. If He's a God of love, He can't forgive me of these things that I've done. But we can read in the Bible of how God just loves to take sinners and change their life, loves to take people with no hope, take people who've done horrible things in their life and change them for the glory of God. He took a deceiver like Jacob, made the promise of the Messiah come through him. He took a murderer like Moses to lead the people of Israel out of Egypt. He took a prostitute like Rahab to help Joshua get out of the city. He took an adulterer like David, made him the king of Israel. He took someone who denied the Son of God face to face like Peter, to preach the gospel of Jesus Christ on the day of Pentecost and win thousands to the Lord. He took a Christian murderer like Paul and changed his life to preach the gospel of Jesus Christ to the Gentiles. 2,000 years ago, when Jesus stretched out his hands on that cross, he was dying for the world. The Bible says that he loved the world so much, that God loved the world, that he gave his only son. And Jesus said this about himself. He says, as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, so must the Son of Man be lifted up, that whoever believes in him will not perish but have eternal life. Jesus became that serpent when he was hung up on that cross. He became that serpent because the sins of every murderer were on him, The sins of every rapist were on him. The sins of every abortion were on him. The sins of every thief, every liar, every idol worshiper, every rebellious child and unfaithful parent, and unfaithful marriage was on him. The sins of every child molester was on the Son of God that day. The sins of every lustful thought and sexual perversion and every hurtful word that's ever been spoken that's hurt someone was on the Lamb of God that day. The Lamb of God who never committed a sin, the hands that never did anything wrong, were stretched out and pierced for us on that day. Today, if you don't know Jesus, I want you to know that when he died on that cross 2,000 years ago, that he did it out of love for you, that you could be forgiven of your sins today. The Bible says in Romans 5:8 that he demonstrated his love for us, that even while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. If you don't know Jesus, he wants to come into your life. He wants to change you. If you've done things that you think nobody can forgive you of, Jesus is opening up the gift of eternal life. He's stretching it out to you today. And he's saying, will you just take this gift? If you don't know him, why don't you just pray this prayer with me right now to accept Jesus into your life. Just say, Heavenly Father, I believe that Jesus came and died for me. I know that he's the Son of God. I want him to be my Redeemer, my God, my Lord, my Savior. Forgive me of my sins. Wash me in the blood of Jesus. Make me a new creature in Christ Jesus. Change my life, oh God. Change my heart and change my mind. Use me to be a witness to this world. Make me a disciple of Jesus Christ. God save me. In Jesus' name I pray. If you prayed that prayer with me today, I just want to encourage you to start your walk with Jesus Christ. Never turn back.